Yeah, power seats would have been so much nicer when I was trying to disassemble all this. Hey Crusaders, Daryl here. Today I'm going to be working on my silver 2003 Montero behind me. Over the weekend, went to a U-Pullet place in Poland, Georgia called Highway 82 Pick and Pay. And scored some really good parts. If you notice behind me over my shoulder right here where my thumb is, I have some damage on the front right fender, so I was able to pick up a new fender, which I'll be installing probably this weekend. And my front driver's seat had some damage and it was patched over, and I found an absolute beautiful replacement front seat in black leather. So I will be replacing that, and that's what I plan on doing today. Also, for an update, I do have extruded aluminum in, so I will be making a roof rack for that soon, and hopefully being able to get out my 270 awning from Rough Country, which I got for Christmas, mount that along with my kick-ass system, my solar panel, and get this ready for the Save Expo coming, I believe it's the first weekend in March, to Stark, Florida. And or Keystone Heights, you should say, and hang out with John Berkmeyer with Florida Adventure Trail or Sunshine State Adventure Company, Brad from Overland Ruse, and I believe Zach and Tracy are going to be there from Sunshine State Vikings, and probably Danon with Adventures with Danon, and also Asia with Baptism Overland. So hope to hang out with those guys and get around and see some new products and hopefully be able to showcase my project, as Doc Martin would say, Project Silverback. So stay tuned and let's get into replacing that front seat. Okay, Crusader, so here's the front seat that I scored. It is a power seat. It does have to be cleaned up a little bit. This is just lime rock from where the yard was located at, but let's get in there close. Look at that. Needs a little cleaning here. Look at that. The side bolsters, they're all firm. They're not ripped. There's no rips here on the side, which is common for the Mitsubishi Monteros. You notice it's all good to go right there. So with it being in such beautiful shape, I plan on getting a nice coat of leather lotion all on that, clean it, leather lotion it, and then I'm going to put a neoprene seat cover on it so I can protect it. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, so the first thing we had to do for the seat install is move the silver one a little bit away from the white Montero. I'm just about done finishing this. All I have to do is take the fuel tank skid plate off and put the factory skid plate on it and clean it up, and this will be ready for the new owner, whoever that might be. So I moved it, gave me some room. Let me show you the interior. All right, so check this interior out. This just needs some good lotion. I gave some to it before, but look how excellent shape this is. The armrest is also an excellent shape. Now, on the driver's seat, you notice I have a neoprene cover on it right now. What I did was, this driver's seat is in excellent condition, except for the actual seat cushion itself. There is some black patchwork. It's like self-adhesive patch. So I just went ahead and put the neoprene seat on it. But that new seat, from what you saw, was in excellent condition. So once I put the new seat where the old seat was, I'm going to put the seat cover right back on it to help protect that leather. So, but let me tell you, this interior looks pretty good. I do have to wash the outside, but I'm working on the interior for now. Okay, for the leather, this is what I use. I use Pro Products, and that is C12 leather cleaner. All right, it says ready to use, contains no harsh alkaline chemicals, gentle pH balance formula, biodegradable, VOC compliant. Safety gently cleans dirt and oil buildup on fine leather. I have used this for years. I was a detailed cars like 25 years ago while I was still a public servant, and I've always used Pro Products. After I clean it, I'm going to be using the Pro Products S44, which is the leather lotion, premium leather conditioner. Thick, rich leather prevents damage, restoration, lanolin. I mean, this stuff works great. So Pro Products, C12 and C44. I believe Pro Products is a national-based company here in the United States. So what I'm doing is I'm just spraying it down. Let the cleaner get in there, get into the pores of the leather. What I didn't show you on the back of the seat, it looks like since it was sitting in the U-pull-up place, may have had a little bit of moisture inside the vehicle. So there did seem to be a little bit of what looked like some little mold starting to form. So spraying the back for that and getting it good and let it soak in. So yeah. You know, so it looks a little dingy right now, but what I'm gonna do is get the leather lotion and go ahead and start lotioning the leather so everything can absorb. So right back here, it's sort of hard to see, but right back here is where the little bit of looked like surface mold, which I got that off. So, love the products. They do a great job. So now let's get some lotion on it. Okay, so we let the leather cleaner dry. It just air dried. And now I'm going to use the Pro Products leather cleaner, the S44. What I normally do is sometimes I can just, you know, dribble it on and work it in, depending on the space you're working at. So I'll do that. Get it in, work it in. Or you could do like you do wax on an applicator, put it on there, work it into the applicator, or in this case a rag. You can use a wax applicator
But just make sure that if you're using the wax applicator, you have an applicator for your leather lotion and an applicator for your wax. You don't want to mix them up, okay? That way, because the lotion is specific for the leather, the wax is specific for your paint. So you don't want to dry out your leather with using wax on it. You want the lotion. Just like your skin, it has pores. You want to keep your skin lotioned. You want to keep your leather lotioned. Especially for us in Florida, with the harsh heat, the harsh sun, especially if it was with a black interior, you definitely want to make sure that you keep your leather protected. Because let me tell you, I just had my wife's two front seats reupholstered and the center console reupholstered, and it came out about $1,400. So I don't want to have to do that again. So it's just thankfully I had the money. But that's just money you don't really want to have to spend, let's just say frivolously spend, on your vehicle. I mean, I could have used that $1,400 for something else. Maybe one of those expensive front runner racks for the Mitsubishi Montero for the roof. So that would have been nice. But my wife's comfort's more important than a front runner rack for my truck. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Of course, I could probably use a couple things of lotion. There's no telling how long it's been since this leather's been lotioned before. But I think that's good. It's gonna hold up nice. We got a little bit cracking right here, but get that thing leathered up, lotioned up, I should say. Put that seat cover on there, and that'll definitely keep it protected. All right, so what I normally do after I put the leather lotion on it, this is just one of those shop towels. It's clean, it's not full of oil and grease or anything. I get a microfiber towel and I just sort of go over it and then buff it out. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put the seat cover on it first before I put it in the vehicle, because it's a lot easier to put the seat cover on outside the vehicle than it was to put it inside the vehicle. So stay tuned. Okay, so I just have a microfiber. I'm just gonna go back over and just sort of buff it a little bit. Try and get any excess lotion off the leather. And then, I think it's looking pretty good. I thought it looked good before I cleaned it. Now it really looks good. And you know about the best part of this? I think since this was an electric seat, I think it may have cost me $33, maybe. For some reason, $32.99 keeps popping in my head. But I'll look. It could have been $25.99. But I think it's one of those two prices. So either way, I think for an electric seat, that's a steal. As opposed to, say, $600 to reupholster it. You tell me. Leave a comment below. Okay, so to remove this seat from the floorboard, there's four attachment points. The front attachment points have one under its cover, which that should be covered right there. So you have two nuts in the front, and one's going to be under here. And then if we go to the back, once I remove the covers, there's going to be, and I move the floorboard right here, and right here is going to be two bolts. So when I was getting the other seat from the vehicle, there was no battery for the electric seats. So thankfully I had a wrench I could get in there and sort of manhandle it. It took twice as long, but I got it done. Okay, so I need to get this cover off. So I should just be able to pop it off with the tool. There you go. And it is a 14 millimeter. There you go. And now I just get over to here, get this one out. There you go. Alright, 214 millimeters. Now, let's go to the back. Alright, I started undoing the seat covers, but the same thing, need to pop the little protective cover. There you go. Pop this little protective cover. Maybe. There we go. Now these are going to be bolts. Remember the front was nuts. These are bolts. So let's see what we can do with these. There you go. 14s. Alright, so we'll just tidy these up, put those out of the way. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to push the seat back so I can lean it back and I can unplug the plugs. Okay, get the seat cover up. Let's see, there's this. This one, I didn't have all the attachments. I'd used the seat cover before, so some of the clips were broken off it. So I just basically tied some knots. There we go. That's off there. So I have this right here. It's part of the electric. This actually pops up like that. And then you just pull it. Squeeze and pull. Little thing right there. Okay. And then the other one is we have, it's always hard when you get the things in the crossbars in the way. There's one, just squeeze down on it. Oh, there's another one. I'm trying to get my hand in there. There we go. Two. Let's see if the third one's just as easy. Once you figure out which way you squeeze it. Oh, okay. You squeeze it from this side. Do you? These little clips are always such a pain in the butt. There we go. See? One, two, three. And now I can go ahead and get it out. Looks like I got a little vacuuming to do before I put the new seat in. You can only vacuum so much when the seat's in. but I guess I got some more vacuuming to do. Here's what I'm talking about with the other seat. See how there's a patch? So you can tell right here, it's ripped. And you can feel it all in here, it's all ripped. And then right here, it's ripped. This is what's famous about the Montero Limited seats. Look at this piece of metal right here. So as the plastic, not the plastic, but the cushion wears out, it exposes the frame. And it just sort of cuts it all in, where the new one doesn't have that. Okay, so I vacuumed it up real quick. Looks a whole lot better. I also noticed this was dirty, so I got my interior cleaner out, cleaned that up. So now I'm ready to put the seat cover on. Take the seat cover off there, put it on the new seat, and then install. All right, I want to show you something real quick. If you ever go to a pull-up place and all you need is just this front seat cover or the seat cushion, you have a 12 millimeter bolt there, a 12 millimeter bolt there, and then if you can see back down in here, where is it? Oh, there it is. There's one right there. And there's also going to be one over in here. I know the camera job is crappy, but there's, so that if you undo those four bolts, you can just get the seat cushion. Okay, so here's the bottom cushion. Just ran it through right here, and then just sort of tied it all up underneath. Makes it nice and easy. Okay, here's the backrest to it. So you have to take the headrest out. Okay, which is no big deal. And then down here, it's a two-piece Velcro. So you slide the one piece of Velcro through the back of the seat cushion, pull it up, pull this down, Velcro, and there you have it. All right. Looks good. Let's install this in the truck now. Okay. Get this in without ripping or damaging anything. There we go. Swinging around. Gonna have to line up some holes. There we go. It's lined up. I'm just gonna hand tighten these for right now. See? Get these hand tight. That way it doesn't go anywhere. And then I gotta connect the connectors underneath. Alright. Which. Okay, so got these wires connected. Connected those three. Plugged it back into where it needs to be plugged into. Now, let's see what happens. Oh, that's a good sign. Goes up. Goes back. Tilt. Oh yeah. Goes up, down. Alright. Okay. Looks like everything works. Lumbar works. Tilting up, back. Raise lower, forward and back. I think that's a pretty good score for like $33. Okay, Crusaders, so that was the front seat install. What I'm going to do is, at another time and off video, I'm just going to remove the passenger front seat, do the same thing with the neoprene seat covers and vacuum underneath it real good and reinstall it. So super simple. If you noticed, I haven't installed all the bolts yet, but I will do that in just a minute. But Crusaders, I want to say, don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and God bless. And I hope to see you and you and you and you and you and you on your own crusade. Also, I hope to see you at Save Expo. I will be at the Florida Adventure Trail booth most of the time. But if you see me out walking around, introduce yourself. I do have some stickers, and maybe I'll randomly give you a sticker. God bless, and I hope to see you on your own crusade.